Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Tralochan Singh from Arunachal University of Studies. I am going to speak on natural resources, a module that comes under the environmental geology. Here we will try to understand what are natural resources, what are the types of natural resources, and how to exploit for sustainable use of the resources, and why it is important to conserve the natural resources. Anything which is required for surviving and improvement of the quality of life is called a resource. These resources come from the nature, such as air, water, and land, hence called natural resources. Need for the natural resources has always been felt ever since the human has evolved on the earth in prehistoric time. In ancient time, our ancestors used to live in jungle and later started living in caves to protect themselves from extreme weather and wild animals. Since food was the basic need, they survived on plant roots, fruits, and animals by killing them for their food. Subsequently, they started covering their bodies with tree leaves and animal skin. Gradually, as the need arose, they discovered various resources to make their life better. Early human beings extracted various natural resources from the earth for food, shelter, tools, and other amenities of life. Natural resources are thus directly linked with the humanity from the ancient time. Our earth is a huge storage house of various resources. The earth is a huge storehouse of various resources which are required in our day-to-day life. It holds air, water, soil, plants, animals, rocks, and many other natural materials of use. Such materials are called natural resources. We use a variety of natural resources every day, directly in terms of water and food, or indirectly in terms of soil, trees, minerals, and various rock types. Some resources are essential for the survival, and others are required for the need and desire of the mankind. Thus, the value of natural resources depend upon the amount of substances available and its requirement by the mankind. Every natural resources form the backbone of economy and development of any nation. Any substance is considered a natural resource only when it is found in nature or extracted or purified and is not created. For example, a pearl. When extracted from a bivalve shell, it is a natural resource. But when produced in the laboratory, it is not considered as a natural resource. Similarly, plants, trees, etc., found in forest are natural resources. But the plants or agriculture crop which are cultivated are not considered as natural resource. Now, categorization of natural resources. We can categorize into renewable natural resources, non-renewable resources, and non-exhaustible natural resources. Let's see one by one. Renewable resources are those which are constantly available and or can be replenished by themselves in a short period of time. For example, forests, animals, microorganisms, etc. Even renewable natural resources are reproduced or replace themselves within the lifespan of a generation and thus never run out. Nutrients in soil, which are made up of various chemicals or mineral components, have also been categorized as renewable natural resources. For example, when an animal or human eats a plant, it takes in nutrients from the plant. These nutrients are used in the body, of which many nutrients may come out as waste, which goes in the soil. Likewise, when animals die, their nutrients return back to the soil as well, and these nutrients are then absorbed by the plant from the soil. Thus, the nutrients move round and round, forming a cycle and never run out. There are some renewable resources which takes a long time to grow or replace. Such renewable resources may be diminished or eventually be die out if these are used up at a much faster rate than the time taken for their replacement or growth in nature. for example, forest, wildlife, biomass, non-agricultural food, etc. Animals, though are renewable resources, yet some of the endangered species are also considered as non-renewable, which are at the verge of being extinct. Now, coming to the next category, non-renewable resources. These resources exist in nature in a fixed amount and cannot be regenerated or replaced at the rate at which these are consumed. For example, various type of minerals, say gold, lead, zinc, coal, oil and natural gas, etc. These are also known as exhaustible resources, as once used, these cannot be replaced or renewed. The non-renewable resources are found both on the earth surface as well as subsurface. The quantity of such resources are fixed and are considered as non-living things. Soil, fossil fuel minerals, etc. are though reproducible, yet these are categorized under non-renewable resources because these take millions of years to be formed. Minerals rich topsoil takes nearly 1000 to 50,000 years to form. The third category is the non-exhaustible resources. These resources can last forever irrespective of human activities such as air, water and sunlight. Although non-exhaustible resources renew on its own continuously in the nature, these can however be deteriorated or degraded or polluted by the human activities, which then becomes harmful and unusable. Now, let us see the types of natural resources. Mainly there are four types of natural resources: the georesources, the hydro resources, the bioresources and atmospheric resources. Under the georesources, we have the land, soil, minerals and rocks and places of nature's scenic beauty. Under the hydro resources, we have surface water and groundwater. Within the bioresources, it comes forests and timber, non-timber products, medicinal plants, wildlife and microorganisms. And under the atmospheric resources, we have air, rain and sunlight. Now, let us see one by one. Let us see, start with the georesources, the land. Land is one of the most important natural resources. It covers nearly 30% of the total area of the earth's surface. It includes rugged topography, mountains, steep slopes, low-lying areas, desert areas and forested areas. Land is used for different purposes such as agriculture, forestry, building of roads and houses, mining and setting up of industries. It is commonly termed as land use. Availability of land is limited, whereas demand of the people for land is increasing consistently. It has led to the land degradation due to large scale destruction of forest cover and arable land. Further, landslides, soil erosion, desertification are the major threats because of the expansion of agriculture and constructional activities. Limited resources of non-renewable minerals and fossil fuels with growing consumption is also a matter of concern that compel us for land conservation. Thus, present rate of degradation of land resources must be checked. Some common methods used to conserve lands are afforestation, land reclamation, regulated use of chemicals, pesticides and fertilizers, and check on overgrazing, etc. Now, the next georesources comes the soil. Soil has remained a source of living for human beings and animals. It also supports, nourishes plant kingdom and thus classified as the basic natural resource. Soil forms a part of the earth's surface and is formed by the long-term processes of complex interaction of climatic, topographic and biological factors through weathering of the parent rock. The formation of soil can be visualized with the formula S is equal to G into E into B multiplied by T, that is S, where S stands for soil, G stands for geology, E stands for environment, B for biological influences and T is the time. You will surprise to know that it is estimated that the formation of 1 inch of soil takes nearly 500 to 1000 years. Now, there are various factors that lead to soil degradation. These are deforestation, overgrazing, overuse of chemical fertilizers or pesticides, rain wash, landslides and flood. As such, erosion and depletion are the major threats to soil as a resource. Now, let us talk about the conservative measures. The first point is the mulching. In this process, the bare ground between plants is covered with a layer of organic matter like straw. It helps to retain soil moisture. Next is the contour barriers. These barriers are built along the contours using stones, grass and soil. Trenches are made in front of the barriers to collect water. Next is to make check dams or bund. It helps to slow down the flow of water. It also prevents formation of gullies and further soil loss. Terrace farming. Flat surfaces are made on the steep slope to grow crops. It reduces surface runoff and soil erosion. Then intercropping or crop rotation is another conservative measure. In this, different crops are sown in alternate rows at different times to protect soil from rain wash. Crop rotation is also adopted to restore soil fertility. Another conservative measure is to nitrogen fixing. Microorganisms may be inoculated into the soil. Then we can also make the shelter belts. In fact, in the coastal and dry regions, rows of trees are planted to check wind movement to protect soil covers. It is known as shelter belts. Now, another georesources is the mineral resources. There are three types of minerals: metallic, which includes gold, platinum, cobalt, nickel, silver, copper, etc. And then non-metallic minerals, that includes graphite, zinc, lead, clay, limestone, etc. And fossil fuel minerals, which includes coal, oil and natural gas, etc. Mineral resources form the basis of industrial development and improvement of the lifestyle of the mankind. Entire mankind largely depends on mineral resources, where minerals play an important role in their day-to-day life. Food, water supply, clothing, health articles, transportation and communication all depends on the mineral resources. There are products in the kitchen such as refrigerator, gas stove, toaster, fork, knife, etc. all made from various minerals. Do you know that it takes more than 33 minerals and elements to make a computer? Even the petroleum industry has a major role in computer manufacturing, as all its components are placed in plastic. Next one is the rock resources. There are three types of rocks: sedimentary rocks, igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks. Sedimentary rocks are formed by the accumulation of sediments either through wind or water. Some of the sedimentary rocks include sandstone, shale, siltstone, limestone, conglomerate. Then igneous rocks are formed from the solidification of molten lava material coming out from the volcanoes. Some of the igneous rocks are granite, pegmatite, rhyolite, gabbro, basalt, diorite. Metamorphic rocks are formed by deformation of sedimentary or igneous rocks by heat, pressure and chemical processes. Some of the metamorphic rocks are quartzite, marble, slate, phyllite, gneiss and schist. See, slates have been used as souvenir in many part of the country. The rocks are also used for making tiles. Now, another georesources is the places of nature's scenic beauty. In fact, nature's scenic beauty is considered as one of the natural sources nowadays, which is being utilized presently in every country in form of tourism industry. It has been proved very successful. More and more virgin areas are now being developed to fetch sound economy. Mountains have always remained a source of curiosity and adventure for the mankind since the time immemorial. But it was never classified as a resource. But as people are suffering from day to day mechanized life and heavy mental pressure of work load due to excess urbanization and industrialization, the people, particularly from the urban areas, now look forward for an opportunity to visit hilly regions from time to time for peace, tranquility and recreation. Even some people visit the Himalayan region for spirituality. Many people like to visit deserts, beaches, etc., which are the nature gift to the mankind. Such scenic beauty places have developed as a fast growing natural resource based activity in form of tourism. Now the next type is the bioresources. Bioresources are those natural resources which are consumed by the human beings for their need and pride. Broadly, bioresources include forest and natural vegetation, wildlife and microorganisms. Forest includes timber and non-timber products. Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects as well as aquatic life forms. Animal, big or small, and even microorganisms are integral to maintain balance in the ecosystem. Next bioresources is the forests and timber. Forests were the main source of survival of the mankind in ancient time, where our ancestors live in forest. Even today, there are many local tribal communities who have the forest as one of the resources for their existence and subsistence. Forests harbor wildlife, maintain ecological balance between oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. It controls wind forces, it provides humus to the soil and prevents soil erosion. Thus, forests play a major role in enhancing the quality of environment and also influence local climate. Forests are important because these are renewable resource. It plays a major role in enhancing the quality of environment. It modifies local climate. It controls soil erosion. It regulates stream flow. It supports a variety of industries. Forests also provide livelihood for many communities. They offer panoramic and scenic view for recreation. They control wind force and temperature and also cause rainfall. And forests provide humus to the soil and also provide shelter to the wildlife. In addition, the forest harbor timber yielding trees and non-timber forest products, including medicinal plants and wild ornamental plants. Non-timber forest products. Forests are rich in the non-timber forest produce, which are extracted from the roots, stems, flowering panicles, fruits, leaves, etc. Based on the end product, the non-timber forest produces of economic importance can be classified into the following categories: bamboo, cane and grasses, resin, wax and gum, spices, edible plants, drug, etc., oil seeds, tan and dye, etc., fiber and flosses, broomstick, toco leaves, etc., and medicinal plants. Medicinal plants have been used in the traditional medical system, particularly the Ayurveda. These have been known as early as 3000 BC in ancient Chinese and Egyptian papyrus writing. Now, another bioresources category is the wildlife. Wildlife is an integral part of the ecosystem and is a source of livelihood. It not only provides useful products but also helps to preserve biodiversity and maintains ecological balance of nature and natural cycle of food chain. Wildlife is a valuable resource. It includes animals, birds, insects as well as aquatic life forms. Insects such as bees provide honey. Insects also help in flower pollination. Wildlife provides milk, meat, wool, etc. The birds feed on insects. The insects also play an important role as decomposers in the ecosystem. So, animals big or small all are integral to maintain balance in the ecosystem. A large number of birds and animals are in danger of getting extinct or on the verge of extinction. These are called endangered species. Other than the endangered species, there are many species classified as vulnerable species and rare species. If we see the definition, endangered species are those which are in danger of getting extinct, whereas vulnerable species are those which have abundant population, but their habitat is adversely affected and may become endangered in near future. And the rare species are those whose population is very thin because of their natural reproduction. Let's come to the conservation of the wildlife. It is necessary to preserve the natural habitats of the wildlife. It is thus utmost important to conserve and maintain diversity and integrity of the natural heritage in its full form, that is physical environment, flora and fauna. It is also important to regulate over exploitation of forest products. We should also provide facilities for education, awareness and training. We must promote research on ecological conservation and other aspects of environmental preservation. And it is also important to establish national parks and sanctuaries to protect wildlife. Initiatives have been taken in this direction. Wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, biosphere reserves have been set up. Microorganisms is the another bioresource. Microorganisms are not seen by the naked eye, but are powerful resources that exist in atmosphere, land, sea, and even in the animals and plants. These include fungi, bacteria, viruses, etc. Some benefits of microorganisms are, these help in natural fixing of nitrogen as symbiotic and non-symbiotic bacteria. Saprophytic bacteria and fungi are responsible for decomposition of plants and animals into simpler products, thereby maintaining ecological balance. Some microorganisms are autotrophs and produce food by photosynthesis. A large number of microorganisms are known to have beneficial characters such as fermentation and curdling, which are commonly employed for the benefit of man. Similarly, many microorganisms are used to manufacture vaccines, medicines, vitamins, acids, proteins, hormones, etc. on commercial scale. The third type of natural resources is the hydro resources. Water has remained a basic human need. As such, most of the ancient civilizations were located on the river banks to ensure regular supply of water for day-to-day activities. Water is a vital renewable natural resource. It is a lifeline not only for the human being, but all living beings. About 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water. However, fresh water amounts to only 2.7%. Of this fresh water, nearly 1% is available and fit for the human use. It is found as groundwater, as surface water in forms of rivers and lakes, and as water vapor in the atmosphere. Now, surface water. There is enough surface water, but fresh water amounts to 2.7% only. This vast resource is primarily utilized for drinking and irrigation purposes. It is being effectively converted into development of inland water transport system, which is a viable mode of cheap transportation. Groundwater. Groundwater is the water that seeps through rocks and soil and is stored below the ground. The underground layers of water stored in the rocks are called aquifers, which may stretch for over hundreds of square kilometers. Groundwater is the main source of drinking water as well as for agriculture and industrial use. Groundwater is an integral part of the hydrological cycle and thus largely depends on the rainfall and precipitation. There is enormous water wealth which is available in form of surface and groundwater. However, with the increase of population and expansion in industry, demand of water has increased over the years, that has led to its scarcity. On the other hand, deforestation has reduced infiltration of surface water, thereby leading to scarcity of groundwater. Another cause is the contamination of surface water. It is polluted mainly by discharge of untreated or partially treated sewage, agrochemicals, and industrial effluents. The common contaminants include arsenic, fluoride, nitrate, phosphate, iron, and heavy metals, and also a variety of bacteria. Most of these chemicals are non-biodegradable, hence are harmful to the human being. Now, the fourth type of natural resources is the atmospheric resources. Human has been blessed with atmospheric resources that provide the basis of life on the earth. These resources include air, rain, sunlight. Sunlight gives atmosphere temperature, that is heat. Air. Air is an important and vital natural resource essential for any living being. Air is not uniform throughout the atmosphere. Its density reduces gradually with the altitude. The composition of air also varies with different layers of the atmosphere. It has 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and 0.03% of carbon dioxide at the surface of the earth. Of these, oxygen is directly responsible for life of living beings on the earth. Next one is the rain. Rain forms a part of atmospheric weather cycle and is responsible for varying ecosystems on the earth. Rain provides water to drink as well as it discharges the subsurface water, also known as groundwater. It helps to grow vegetation and agriculture crops. Farmers consider rain as the nature's gift that facilitates them to harvest crops. They look for this gift particularly during drought. When chemicals present in atmosphere are mixed into the rain, fog, or mist, then rain becomes acidic. The acid comes from sulfur oxides and nitrogen oxides, which are emitted by vehicles, oil refineries, industries, etc., into the atmosphere. These gases, when react with rainwater, forms sulfuric acid and nitric acids. Hence, such rain is called acid rain, and we must protect ourselves from this acid rain. Then the next category is the sunlight. Sunlight is a renewable natural resource that provides light, heat, and energy. It is the prominent source of natural light for the human being on the earth. Sunlight is also a potential source of vitamin D, particularly D3. Sunlight is utmost important and integral part of the plant life also, where plants, particularly leaves, absorb sunlight for photosynthesis process that produce energy for the growth of plants. Sunlight also governs soil fertility, hydrological cycle, and many other abiotic and biotic parameters of the earth. The sunlight is being used as the solar energy. It also provides enough heat to regulate the environment around the human being. Now, coming to the exploitation and sustainable use of the natural resources. Natural resources which are directly or indirectly utilized are important for livelihood of the human society. Hence, these resources must be protected and managed suitably. Initially, the mankind used natural resources to fulfill their basic needs. Subsequently, with the advancement in science and technology, the mankind started manipulating these resources for their higher order of need and greed. It resulted into environmental and ecological problems. While the land resources and hydro resources in a particular geographical area are limited or fixed in quantity, bioresources in the same area keep on varying in time and space with interference of the human activities. Human efforts and available resources should be put to obtain maximum gains. The society should have a positive attitude toward the nation and its economic development. For example, Japan is poor in natural resources base, but is the only nation in Asia having the status of a developed country. On the other hand, African countries are full of geo-resources, yet they are economically poor. It shows that human attitude makes the nation develop rather than availability of resources as such. America is the example, who looks forward to have the best talent in the world to develop its natural resources. That is why America is the number one country in the world as far as economic development and science and technology is concerned. Thus, need is to identify the priorities of resources utilization for socio-economic development. Natural resources or goods produced from these resources form the basis of economy in the developing countries. It may be in form of minerals, oil and natural gas, forest, tourism, etc. Even the local trade is based on the niche resources. According to the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, the livelihood of poor people has remained dependent on natural resources. The organization identified 7 natural resources sectors for sustaining pro-poor growth. These are fisheries, soil productivity, forests, water security, minerals, renewable energy, and wildlife and nature-based tourism. Now, let's come to the conservation of natural resources. Exploitation of natural resources is a key factor in economic growth and development. However, it can have serious negative environmental and socio-economic impacts if exploited unsystematically and unscientifically. It is often observed that certain resources are overexploited, whereas many others are not being able to utilize or are underutilized. For example, forest resources are overutilized, leading to environmental and ecological problems, whereas a variety of other resources, particularly mineral and water resources, are either underutilized or still in dormant stage in many states. It is essential to conserve natural resources, particularly the non-renewable resources. Even some renewable resources also need conservation, which may run out if overused or may not be usable if polluted. So, thumb rule for conservation may be the 3 R's: reduce, recycle, and reuse. Reduce means using limited natural resources and avoiding wastage, such as turned off light when you are not in room. It will reduce fossil fuel used to generate electricity. You may ride on bicycle to reduce the amount of fuel used in the transport vehicles. Recycle means the items such as paper, plastic, glass, metal, etc. be used for making new things. Effort may be made to use the things which can be recycled. Reuse means using the items again and again, such as bottles in which we buy jams, pickle, or any other such item can be used again for storing things in the kitchen. Another important aspect is the indigenous people knowledge about various medicinal plants and herbs that are growing wild in abundance. This indigenous knowledge may prove to be invaluable for management and sustainable utilization of these natural resources. Hence, efforts may be made to document this wealth. Natural resources are also related with the hazards. Exploitation of natural resources has a serious impact on environment and natural hazards. On the other hand, man-made and natural hazards such as deforestation, soil erosion, constructional activities, forest fires, tsunamis, and landslides all affect the natural resources to a greater extent. It has been seen that natural disasters have both positive as well as negative impacts on natural resources. The positive impacts, let's see. Floods improve soil fertility by transferring nutrients from the upland to the lowland and temporarily creates a water habitat for fishes and other aquatic animals. Likewise, typhoons and floods also increase moisture contents in the air and also dilute air pollution. Whereas the negative impacts, if we see, the floods cause soil erosion, siltation and sedimentation, waste accumulation, water pollution, deformation of land, topography, etc. Even the drought results into low soil fertility and increase in salt water intrusion. Now, pollution is biggest enemy of the natural resources, particularly air and water. Waste disposal and garbage dumped in open roadside, toxic gases produced from industries and harmful chemical waste from industries all cause pollution that becomes a threat to the natural environment cycle. Now, let us see how to manage the natural resources. Natural resources are the heart line of any state or nation for its economic growth. It, however, depends upon the extent and intensity of utilization of these niche resources. Increasing pressure of human interference for their need have influenced the natural resources, causing environmental degradation and imbalance in developmental processes, which has already reached to an alarming stage. There are cases where a state is not able to reap economic benefit in spite of being rich in natural resources. Arunachal Pradesh, for example, in spite of being resource rich and having low population, economy of the state is very poor. Further exploitation must be done within the tolerable limits. In this context, example of over exploitation of limestone in Mussoorie Hills is cited, which resulted into depletion of forest cover and water sources. It caused drastic change in climatic conditions and increased landslide incidences. So much so that the Honorable Supreme Court has to interfere. After the intervention of the Honorable Supreme Court, mining was totally banned, and subsequently a Green Brigade in terms of Eco Task Force of the Indian Army was constituted to take up mass afforestation program to restore the beauty, environment and climatic conditions of the regions. Here the result can be seen, how the Mussoorie Hill looks before the intervention of the Honorable Supreme Court, and this next picture shows the how it looks after restoration and greening of Mussoorie Hills by Army Eco Task Force Battalion. As already mentioned, most of the natural resources are diminishing rapidly, not only due to the increasing pressure of growing population, but also by their ruthless exploitation with passage of time. There is need to bring awareness among the people to conserve resources and is environmentally sustainable technologies. It is possible through transfer of scientific knowledge about natural resources at the grassroots level. It, however, requires a strong database. A considerable amount of data may be available in various departments or agencies, but quite likely it may show variance owing to their specific need and subjective nature. This data has to be designed in such a way that it could cater the need of any user's agency as per their specific planning and development. Since development is a continuing process, it is equally important to update the existing data regularly. A sound, integrated and area-specific spatial database on natural resources and socioeconomic parameters forms the backbone of any developmental plan. Therefore, the database should be so designed that adequate data is available to initiate investigations for a detailed study. It could supplement or modify the existing data subsequently. The data could be utilized by various departments, organizations, agencies and other end users as per their need, and it could provide internal consistency to each sectoral planning, that is at block and district level or at watershed level. The Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, has launched a project on natural resources data management system way back in 1982. The database centers in various districts were set up for development of GIS based database for decision support in planning at local level. These district database centers proved successful in integrated resource planning. It also helped to tackle unforeseen difficulties in many developmental schemes. In this module of natural resources, we have learnt today that natural resources are any substance that occur in nature which is useful to the mankind, where some are essential for the survival and many others are required for the need and desire of the mankind. Man is dependent on natural resources, which even form the basis of national economy. Natural resources not only form the heartline of the development of the region, but also help to maintain the ecosystem. Natural resources are diminishing rapidly, not only due to the increasing pressure of the human population, but also by the ruthless exploitation with the passage of time. Non-renewable resources need much attention, which are in fixed quantity. Even some renewable resources may also finish if overused, or may not be usable if polluted. Every human being should realize the importance of conserving the natural resources and adopt suitable mitigation measures to preserve these resources. Thank you.